Good afternoon. My name is Glenda Sims, and I'm here to present on practical accessibility testing for enterprise websites. Let me introduce myself a little bit better. I'm Glenda the Good Witch Sims. I'm a senior accessibility consultant at DeQ, where I get to share my passion and expertise for the open web with .gov, .edu, and companies ranging from small business to Fortune 500. I'm also an accessibility consultant, judge, and trainer for the nonprofit Nobility. And I give back to the web by volunteering on the Web Standards Project. Oh, and I did spend over a decade as the accessibility expert and advocate at the University of Texas at Austin. Let me tell you the story of what it was like being the accessibility expert at the University of Texas at Austin. UT is a very large university with 50,000 students and 20,000 employees. We had over 1 million web pages and an extremely distributed web environment. I often described it as separate kingdoms, where each college, like the College of Engineering, the College of Liberal Arts, the College of Natural Sciences, where each college at UT had its own king, the dean, and each college had its own website and its own webmaster. And none of these webmasters reported to me. In fact, there were over 1,000 webmasters on campus. Talk about an incredible challenge. But I'll be honest with you, I'm a girl that loves a big challenge, and I also saw this as an awesome opportunity. What gave me the energy to be so optimistic about improving accessibility at the University of Texas? Well, I wasn't alone. In fact, I had two internationally known accessibility experts at my side, Dr. John Slayton and Sharon Rush. When I first met John, he was a professor at UT who had lost his vision due to retinal disease. Instead of letting his disability limit him, he became an accessibility expert, opened an accessibility research institute at the university, and for a short time even served as co-chair of the WCAG 2.0 working group before his untimely death in 2008. I also had Sharon Rush, executive director of Nobility, at my side. Her nonprofit is dedicated to barrier-free IT, and she's a well-known accessibility expert and a tireless advocate for accessibility. So, in the summer of 2002, we set about trying to figure out how to make the University of Texas more accessible. We began with a manual test of the UT homepage and every link off the homepage for accessibility. So we tested about 114 pages. The first test revealed that fewer than 40% of the pages we tested were accessible. Our next step was to fix all of those accessibility errors on any page that we, the UT Central web team, controlled. Then we contacted each of the owners of the other pages and offered them training, consulting, and motivation to fix the errors on their own homepages. By the fall of 2002, we had already raised our scores on this limited set of pages to 90% accessible. And by the spring of 2003, we're at 98%. Yes, this was only the homepages of these top-level sites, but it was a good start. While the manual testing is useful, there's no way for a large enterprise to manually test everything. We have to use accessibility testing tools wisely. I think of accessibility testing tools as coming in three flavors. First, tools that could be used to test pages one by one, such as standards validators. Second, accessibility authoring tools that help monitor accessibility as content is being created and published to the web. And third, enterprise accessibility reports. So let's look at these a little closer. The accessibility validators page by page are often free tools. Here I've listed a number of them that are commonly used, from the W3C, CSS HTML validators, to WorldSpace and FireEyes by DeQ, to the Wave by WebAIM, Web Developer for Firefox, Accessibility Toolbar for IE, Luminosity Contrast Ratio Analyzer from JazzLemon. All of these tools are useful in the page-by-page accessibility validation process. And as much as we like to use testing tools, it still requires the human brain to do the complete testing. Another critical step in testing is with actual assistive technology. For example, I often test representative pages with JAWS, a screen reader, to see what problems actually occur. But it wasn't until I finally got my hands on enterprise-level accessibility testing tools that I felt that I was making progress. It was then that I felt like I had just had the accessibility super friends join forces with me. Enterprise tools let you define accessibility scans by URL and select your testing criteria. Do you want to use WCAG 2.0 level A, or do you want to go to level AA or level AAA? And then you get to run these reports on a regular basis. I found monthly to be the most useful. And I could see reports of progress over time. The power of this kind of a dashboard is enormous. Here is an example of a fictitious university using the WorldSpace Enterprise testing tool. Imagine being able to see which of your web properties are doing well, which ones are doing poorly, to be able to see what types of errors occur most frequently. Having an enterprise accessibility testing tool at UT Austin made all the difference in the world. Now I could see what was going on, and I could motivate areas at UT to improve their scores and see who needed the most help. In fact, when I set up a similar dashboard at the university, I set it up so that as each webmaster logged in, they didn't just see their scores, they saw everyone else's scores and how they rated. It was an intrinsic motivator. You also need to empower all of your web developers with a desktop accessibility tool so they can see exactly where the problems are with the press of a button as they're developing pages. FireEyes is a wonderful desktop testing tool that is free from DQ. Here's a screenshot of the FireEyes testing plugin in Firefox. It is a plugin that works with Firebug. In this screenshot, I'm in Firefox and have pulled up the homepage of Hawaii.gov. I've opened the FireEyes plugin within the browser and clicked on the setting tab. In the setting tab, I simply selected that I wanted to test against WCAG 2.0 AA. I could have picked any standard and gone down another level and even selected individual success criteria. But for this test, I want to go WCAG 2.0 AA everything. Then you simply run the test by pulling up any web page in your browser and clicking the Now button to have FireEyes test against that standard for you, in this case WCAG 2.0 AA. In the screenshot, if you got up and looked really close at the screen, you'd see that there are 69 issues being reported on this page. It's that line highlighted in yellow. And you could also see that the first error listed is an image is missing a text equivalent. If we look a little deeper, to the far right of each of these errors in FireEyes is a button labeled Details. When I press the Details button, I get a full explanation of the error, including the source code for the error and the standard associated with this particular error. So for the first issue of Images Missing a Text Equivalent, we can see in the detail window that this error is associated with WCAG 2.0 Level A Success Criteria 1.1.1. If we scroll down further in this detail window, we would see an explanation of what a text equivalent is, how to remediate the issue, and even a code sample. Another nice feature in FireEyes is the ability to highlight where this error is occurring on the web page in the graphical browser display. This helps the sighted developer see where the issue is on the page in a visual context. By the way, FireEyes is accessible for people with disabilities as well. While this particular feature might not prove helpful to a developer with visual disabilities, they would be able to access all the features I'm showing you. Now, the next feature I'm going to show you is really dreamy. If we just click on the Inspect button for this particular error, we are taken right to the line of code in Firebug where the issue is occurring. Let's see what that looks like. Being able to see the actual code that is causing the error and the context within the rest of the source code for this page within Firebug is priceless, especially for the developer who now needs to go fix that error. As valuable as these enterprise-level accessibility testing tools are, whether it's the WorldSpace dashboard or the free FireEyes plugin, nothing ever replaces actual user testing. I always recommend usability testing of representative pages of a site with actual people who have disabilities. My favorite reference on the subject is Just Ask, Integrating Accessibility Throughout Design by Sean Lawton Henry. Many of you may already be aware of this wonderful book, and the fact that the entire book is also available for free online, totally awesome. Way to go, Sean. So when it gets right down to it, I believe you must use a multi-tiered accessibility testing plan. I start with code validation, manual browser testing, then I run online accessibility testing tools like FireEyes on representative pages. This gives me a sense of what is going on with a given site. Next, I pull out assistive technology, like a screen reader, to see what barriers I encounter. And while I'm doing this manual testing, I have an enterprise accessibility report like WorldSpace running in the background. And I'm the kind of girl who really likes to run that enterprise scan across the whole site, because I do not want to be fooled by a site that might be clean on the first few levels, but full of accessibility problems in the lower level pages. So running an enterprise scan is a bit like having eyes in the back of my head. And last, but certainly not least, I conduct hands-on accessibility testing, because I don't think a site is accessible until I see that it can be used as effectively by a person with a disability as by a person without a disability. I'll end by saying that accessibility testing is a critical ingredient in building accessible websites. But the only way to have truly accessible web development is to begin with accessibility in mind. No matter what software development lifecycle you use, whether it's Agile or Waterfall, you have to plan for accessibility at the design phase. You have to equip and empower your team for accessible development at the code phase. You have to test and remediate for accessibility at the quality assurance phase, and continuously monitor for accessibility after launch. What does this mean in the way of enterprise testing? During the design phase, you need to set your accessibility testing standard. During the coding phase, you better make sure your developers and your content contributors have the tools they need to test as they create. During the test phase, of course, your quality assurance testers must have accessibility testing tools to check to make sure that everything is on target. And don't assume that just because it was accessible at launch, it stays that way. Enterprise scans are going to give you the ability to test over time, once a month, on a regular basis, and discover when accessibility falls off the table on any given website.